seemed like a good idea at the time.
As with many things in life, there are things that can just fully seem like a good idea. It doesn't necessarily mean they are. You can look at a situation and go, yes, it seems reasonable that this is how I will behave and how the people around me will behave. And, you know, might not be a good idea, but with the outcomes that are expected, it could be reasonable to assume that a given situation, such as a job or something else, that the outcome is to be expected, that you've had a similar outcome based on the amount of input that you've put in it before, so it would be reasonable to assume that what you're doing is the right thing to do. What I'm discovering more and more, because it was my 51st birthday a couple days ago, what I'm discovering more and more is that I actually think a lot of what we're expected to do on a day-to-day basis is the things that we ask of ourselves in the guise of being a good guy, a hard worker, loyal, all of these other things are really quite detrimental to our personal well-being. So the collective, so to speak, which in a capitalistic sense, the collective is really just my boss. It's not me. I don't substantially benefit from the amount of work that I put in to further his business and his finances and everything else. And the more that I put in, the less I'm actually getting for my time. So if I have to do a specific job in a specific time and I can do it in half that time, I still get the same amount of money, but he'll probably jam a second job in there. So he's literally getting twice as much work. And I personally think that that's unreasonable, especially since there isn't even a thanks for doing a good job. So, reasonableness. It can be difficult. Now, if you're working for yourself, sometimes your expectations or sometimes what you need to put upon yourself is unreasonable, but it's still a completely different scenario. A lot of relationships, marriages, parents and children, a lot of those relationships are quite unreasonable. As children get older, the sociopathic communist tendencies that children have should get less and less and less if you're, as a parent, are actually teaching your children correctly to value hard work and integrity and all these other things. Anyway, it's reasonable to expect that sort of outcome. But we're in a world, in a time of helicopter parenting, where no one skins their knees. You know, when we were kids, it was come home when the streetlights come on, and that's basically it. There were not really any other rules. And I think back at some of the stuff that we did when we were kids, but then I see other people's kids that basically don't do anything that doesn't involve having a rectangular screen in front of their face. It's just a different world that we live in, and I can't say whether it's better or worse, but a lot of people just aren't willing to put in the hard work. And then you get a bunch of people that think the shiny bum brigade, the ones that sit in offices, the ones that were able to work from home during the lockdowns, that they believe they make the world go around. They believe that without them, everything would grind to a halt. But they can't fix anything. I know a bunch of people that can't change a tire, wouldn't know how to open the bonnet of their car, wouldn't know what to read on the dipstick, even though it says full and empty, or full and fill, or whatever. There's clear delineations on almost every dipstick, which is the dipstick is the stick that goes into the oil to tell you how much lubricant is in your engine, that if it runs out, your engine dies. But most people wouldn't even know that. I mean, don't get me wrong, I don't check mine all that frequently, but that's because I check so many of them all the time that I just get a massive case of the CBFs when it comes to my own private vehicle. But all these people, and there's a lot of people that think the world would end if they didn't do their personal job, where they're not growing food, they're not building or repairing vehicles, they're not building houses, they're not doing anything, They're pushing papers from one side of an imaginary thing to the other side of an imaginary thing. And at the end of the day, very few of these jobs deal with any substantiative, physical, real-world structure that's going to stop people, that's going to make the world end if they cease. Cities produce almost nothing, and unfortunately cities dictate policy for governments because there's so many people that live in them. So then all these stupid ideas that people have about things that originate in the cities that will never actually affect them in the city. So you go, oh, okay, well, we need to burn less fuel. I can walk to my work or I can work from home. But yeah, then you've got the farmer that it's 3,000 measurement units from his house to the nearest shop and he can only go three times a year. But if he has to switch to a diesel-powered machine, what's he going to have to stop 15 times to recharge it? Nobody is in their own lane, and we've gotten to the point that there isn't actually even any lanes anymore. And it is patently unreasonable for people to fight against farmers. Go, oh, well, you know, well, I saw a video the other day that's like a hunter. There was a guy hunting and he had a deer and they're going, oh, why'd you murder the deer? We all go to the shop to get meat. Where does the meat in the shops come from? Pretty sure him hunting the deer was far more humane than lining these things up in this blood-soaked area where they're all full of fear and you bolt gun them in the head. Perspective is lost, scale is lost, and it's unreasonable for people to put demands on other people when they have not a fucking clue about what's actually going on. Anyway, it's all I've got to say about that. If you can't be good, tough shit, be somewhat primitively nice to one another, I guess, if you want. Cheerio.